Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Thursday, SpaceX launched the Starlink 5-6 mission successfully on a Falcon 9 rocket.
2-1, ignition, and liftoff of Starlink 5-6. Go Starlink, go Falcon.
The booster which launched this mission, B1069, then landed successfully for the seventh time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 1 landing burn.
And there's confirmation that the stage 1 landing burn has started in preparation for touchdown on our drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas. We can now see our drone
ship. Stage 1 landing light deploy. Stage 1 landing is confirmed.
And this Falcon 9 first stage has now successfully launched and landed for the seventh time. We are now coming up on second engine cutoff.
We can hopefully expect to see the next Starlink mission launched this coming week. The Starlink 5-9 mission is scheduled for Friday 12th at 3:52 a.m. UTC or Thursday 11th at 11:42 p.m. EDT. There's also another Starlink mission scheduled for this coming week as well. The Starlink 5-9 mission is scheduled for Friday 12th at 3:52 a.m. UTC or Thursday 11th at 11:42 p.m. EDT. There was an article posted related to the number of Starlink satellites in space now after the recent Starlink mission. It says SpaceX surpassed more than 4,000 Starlink internet satellites in orbit with the launch of a Falcon 9 rocket and another batch of 56 spacecraft Thursday from Cape Canaveral, the company's fourth mission in less than a week. Heading to Boca Chica, a panel was seen removed from the orbital launch mount. Work is continuing to repair the orbital launch mount. As we saw last video, this cover was removed from the mount recently. The thrust simulator was removed from the Pad A test mount. Work was seen going on at the orbital tank farm with crews here working on a LOX tank. Work continues to build sections for the new high bay. They are taking shape very quickly. SpaceX did some cryogenic testing of Starship 25 at Massey's. Ship 29 was seen moved in the high bay. As always, I have to say thanks to Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.